Darlings, welcome back to the Bling Bling Show. I'm Jane, your host. This is discussion time. This is the space to share and learn from each other. Today, we're going to talk about an interesting topic, global citizenship. So, we have one guest in the show today to tell us about her point of view about it. She is Rutger Kontibun. She is on her way to be a global citizen. Hi, Ben. So nice to see you here with us. So I will give a space for you to present. Please sit yourself. Thank you. Thanks, Jen, for having me on your wonderful show today. By the way, your today outlook is so gorgeous. Okay, hello, everyone. Very nice to meet all of you. So, very firstly, my name is Tibben. I'm a fourth-year student of Kunta University, majoring in Interpreting and Translation English, course 44. I was born in Kunta too, and have 21 years of experience living in this peaceful city. Then, I'm talking about who I am. I just want to show you a little bit about myself.
Here's what represents myself, which I call the circles of my life. At the center of these circles, we have the word healer. That is what I dream to be. I see myself and others see me. The next one is about my core subjects in life. The third one is about my characteristics, my personality, whatever you call. With these characteristics, I will show out some of them, but mostly I like to hide them well. Next grad is about my hobbies, my favorite things to do in life. About dreaming, I really love doing that. I imagine so much to create a blog just to type out these. The fifth one is being split to show my strengths and weaknesses. I guess you can infer that the left side is about my strengths and the right one is about my weaknesses. You know, when I create this split circle, it takes me quite a long time. But after finishing it, I have the unimaginative satisfaction, just like I realize that I can move further in my life path. And the final one, which cover all of these, is about what I desire to do. Just two, but big, especially the helping others one.
After taking two courses about global citizenship of Microsoft and Coursera, I can inform my own definition of global citizenship.
It's simple, but also complicated. Think and act globally. I will give you two examples about people around me who are global citizens. The first one is my current teachers, Mr. Nguyễn Duy Khang. I love studying with him because of his creativity in teaching methods and his enthusiasm to teach his students how to become global citizens. He's traveling through many countries to learn new things to convey his experience to people who need it. I'm always astonished about his energy spreading to us. I'm motivated so much about learning to be a better person, also a global citizen. The second person that I want to talk about is my relative sister, Ms. Vong. She's an investor and a freelancer in designing and marketing with global incomes. She also devotes herself in trying to help other youngsters by teaching them about information technology skills. And just like Mr. Heng, she knows about most of the matter existing which affecting the world right now. From AI to Bitcoin, social security to politics, vaccination, she has traveled herself almost regions in Vietnam and some Southeast Asian country.
So, as you can see from two wonderful people here, the features to define someone to be a global citizen is presented quite clean.
They are open-minded, they're hungry for knowledge. They know exactly who they are, what they want to do, and how to do it. They dare to raise their voice, to fight for what they believe. They are very skillful in the major as well as in their lifestyle. They have the desire to support others and the ability to help others to be better in many ways. They care about the world. They can talk about almost all global matter, and they really want to contribute to the world diversity.
So, with my definition, are you a global citizen? I'm on my way to be a global citizen. In my opinion, global citizenship is very important in our modern day, especially when the globalization influence spread out every area around the world. We live in the time when we are overwhelmed by many products from over the world. Therefore, if we don't understand fully about global citizenship, we will lose our identity before globalization wave. We learn about global citizenship not only to connect with the world, but also to preserve and develop our own society with the slogan
Integration without assimilation.
After taking D courses, one significant thing that I've learned in these courses about the enthusiasm of the guys. I see the passion of conveying knowledge to help others to be better. I just remember one sentence that I've read in Microsoft course.
We cannot change the world if we know nothing about it.
In my university, I see that what a youngster like a lot is about soft skills. Most of them, including me, are not ready for international working environment. We don't have enough ability to talk about global matters, and we don't dare to share. I'm in that situation too. However, after 3 years being actively passive to observe, I decided to step out and join ESL Club with the desire to help others, also myself, improve essential skills for life as well as for working environment. In here, I've met excellent people who I choose to stand up, to share, and to be better day by day.
In a larger view, I believe a youngster in Vietnam care about the world too. They try to change fixed mindset of Vietnamese. They hold many projects to raise Vietnamese awareness about many things around us.
I think that there is an urgent need for us to cooperate to create a larger community, to have a bigger influence, and to get the government attention to receive the greater support.
In global scale, we can see many issues emerge across the world, from environmental issues, gender equality, global health issues, to very complicated one, religious matter.
The world now needs a large number of global citizens from all the regions to cooperate to find a solution to enhance development and make the world worth living. I care about some aspect of our life, especially environment and gender equality. I have applied the lifestyle less plastic ways for 4 years. I also started to practice being a half vegetarian to reduce meat consuming because, you know, breeding cattle is one of serious reasons of environmental pollution. And I'm so happy to inform that my family has used clean energy, namely solar power, in every activity. I also start to raise my voice to things that I believe unfair and restrict my freedom through my blog. I also start to be active in many activities in classes and in the club that I participate. That's what I'm proud about myself. And I want to spread my energy to all of my friends and who watched this video. In my point of view, the need condition to be a responsible global citizen is to understand ourselves. Only when we have the ability to recognize who we really are, we can find our core subject in life and then try to practice it to truly help others. To achieve this need condition, after spending time talking with myself, I talk with other people around me. I learn from books. I start to try new things like creating blog, making video, learn some courses online, be open to everything, respect the differences around me, respect my feelings, my changes, my choices, and devote myself to accomplish these choices. Regardless it's good or bad, the pandemic is the great time to try something new and to connect. Because I haven't seen we are so close like this. Opportunities being around us, just wait for us to click in and then we can open a new world. Just move step by step and then we can achieve that. I believe so. I'm so humble, very humble, extremely humble. I cannot give you any advice, but I hope that after watching my sharing, you can partly recognize something which may change your life or maybe which you want to fix. I am learning about how to be a global citizen. How about you?